Hey guys, how you guys doing? It's your boy Mr. J, man. What's good, man? It's a pretty hot Saturday out here. I hope that you're having a great time wherever you are. So, yes. Today, we are going to be talking about the situation in Cameroon. My take on the notion and the idea that Nigerian music should be banned or stopped in Cameroon. But before we get started, man, I just wanted to pause for a minute, hit that subscribe button, smash the like and the notification, okay? Smash the like. Leave us a comment. It's a communal thing. Let's talk in the community. You dig? Now, why would anybody in Cameroon, let alone a bunch of artists, think that this is ideal for the industry in Cameroon? See, I'm gonna give you my takes. I'm gonna give you my takes and you know my points and why I think that this is the most silly thing, the most ridiculous idea of lame ducks. First things first, that would never happen because these guys are not ministers or they have no say in the telecommunication sector of Cameroon. That's the first thing, you know, because we all know that for things to change in Cameroon, decisions like this come from hierarchy, the top bosses, you know. I don't think that the minister of telecommunication of, you know, would just come up and say, the minister of communication would just come up and say, hey, let's stop playing music from this country because we want our industry to grow. It is ideal, but in today's society, that is never going to happen. Secondly, these folks, I'm sure they are artists who would just flirt with an ideal notion like this. Secondly, these folks are not even connected to the Ministry of Art and Culture. Art and culture is, you know, it's in charge of all of these artists, music production, movie production, you know, registering artists as artists in the country. So far, I don't see any of that happening. That's the second point. Because if the Minister of Arts and Culture says, okay, hey, you know what? This music, the music from Nigeria is not ideal for the Cameroonian audience. Okay, they might, you know, they might start a movement to start censoring radio stations, you know, who somehow play these songs. But as long as these folks are not any of that, let's grab that off the table. Now, the third point that I'm going to give you to show you that this is something that will never, ever, ever happen is the Cameroonian music industry is not united, you know? They are so united and so disorganized that to dream of something like this happening, it's not going to happen. You know, there's a statement that united we stand, divided we fall. If you look at the Cameroonian industry, it's very easy to say and to pinpoint that they are very disorganized and they are very disunited. And I'm going to say this, confused to a certain level, because there is actually no control in the industry. What do I mean by control in the industry? They don't have the decency of saying that, okay, you know, these type of music, these people do, kind of like they don't self-screen themselves. I don't know if that makes sense. Like, they just let any kind of dumb stuff being put on air. They just let any, you know, if you can grab a mic, you got some money, you hit the studio, you record a few things, you say a few things, they consider you an artist. And to them, to their mind, they are stars. So that, first of all, is never going to happen, because the industry that you guys are trying to block in your country, look at them. Look at where Nigeria started. I don't think the Nigerian music industry is more than 25 years old. No, it's not even up to 20 years old. It's recent years that these guys started putting the work, and they together, they grew. They developed what we call the Nigerian music industry today. It's not been 20 years. I can tell you that. You know what I mean? At least not 30. Okay? Now, the other point is this. Jealousy. Yes. If you are jealous or you are envious of another person's industry, you try to stop them because your audience is consuming a lot of their products. You're jealous, you're envious, you wish that you were them. So you say, hey, maybe we should flirt with the idea of stopping Nigerian music in Cameroon. That is, first of all, too lame. Second of all, that is stupidity. Third of all, that is sheer ignorance. To think that to push out their music from the Cameroon industry, your music is going to grow. Now, it's not about their music. And this will lead me to the next point. To my next point. Your music suck. Well, not all of them. But you guys, you are not professionalized in your music approach. Mind you, this is coming from a Cameroonian brother. And I know a whole lot of my Cameroonian people, oh, you got to be patriotic. No. Let's call a spade. Because I've seen that over the years, being patriotic has made you guys do nothing. You do bullshit and you think that people, because we are Cameroonian, we have to applaud. I know this, you know, I'm not going to do that. Unfortunately, you guys know my stance on these things. This Mr. Just not starting this. I just started this platform today. And I've been that critic that, you know, I criticize so that people can evolve. You know what I mean? Look at the Nigerian music industry. They professionalize everything. You see, an artist will come up down, not, you know, but the packaging. As some of you guys say, packaging. Now, if you know, packaging is going to get you the respect across Africa and across the world, like the Nigerian artists are doing. What is stopping you from doing the same thing? My old man always told me, man, there's nothing wrong in copying from good examples. You dig? So what is stopping you from, you know, copying the same thing, doing your music, packaging the shit in the same thing? Now, I'm going to applaud you guys because in Cameroon, every, you know, you guys do videos. Every artist comes, he has to do a video. I mean, they do good-ass videos, you dig? So that I give it to you, but it's not about the video, though. The mentality that some of my Cameroon artists think is, all right, if I do a project and I put it online, that's it. Oh, I hit the ceiling. Nah. There's a whole lot of things that artists in Nigeria do that my Cameroonian artists don't do. Yes, you shoot up, you do a project, you do a video. What about the digital promotion? Yes, they promote their stuff, which is why they are known globally. So to think that you would just do music and put it on YouTube and then you're gonna be a star, grow up from it, man. Take, for example, we have YouTubers that start channels and it takes 4 to 6 years, 4 to 7 years before they blow up. Is that what you're trying to do? Nigerian artists don't do that. They plan, they package, they promote their stuff, and that is why they get the accolades. Now, Nigeria is over 250 million people. Now, picture if an artist does a project and only 1 million people buy it. At, let's say, 10 naira. Multiply 10 naira by 1 million. You get the picture. In Cameroon, it's difficult for me to say that 1 million people buy an artist's stuff when it comes off. I'm talking about off the bat. It might take a year or 2 years and you guys sell 1 million units. But that should be the goal. You smell me? So this is my first take for, you know, this whole mess. So to my Cameroonian artist audience, shut up, wake up, do good music, first thing, package your ish, second thing, you dig, screen your industry, who is lame and who is foolish, point that out, don't sit out.